What's up guys, Perry from Rockville here, and today I'm going to show you how to set up your PT65BR 6.5 inch powered Bluetooth LED tower speakers. As you can see, it comes with the speakers themselves, one active and one passive, two non-slip pads, rubber slips in different sizes so you can fit the speakers onto the bar, four 1.75 inch rings and four 2 inch rings so you can fit the speakers onto different size bars, four washers, four nuts and four screws. Also included is an aux cable, an RGB extension cable, a wire harness, and a wireless remote control to control your LEDs. You're also going to need an Allen key to install these speakers. Now attached to the active speaker, we have an RCA line output so we can connect the speakers onto external amplifiers, subwoofers, or speakers, an aux input so we can connect our aux cable for music sources, and the input for our wire harness so we can connect the speakers to a battery or vehicle. So now if we take a look at this wire harness here, you'll see all of these wires attached to it so that we can connect our speakers to our vehicle or battery. The yellow 12 volt wire is used to connect to the positive terminal of your battery. The black ground wire will be used to connect to the negative terminal of your battery or the metal chassis of your vehicle. The red ACC wire will connect to the 12 volt ignition switch, and the blue remote wire will connect right into your head unit. There's also these black and gray output wires that we can use to connect the active speaker to the passive speaker. And like I mentioned before, we would use the RGB extension cord to connect the RGB cables of each speaker together so that they both light up. Now the PT65BRs come built with a 360 degree swivel bracket so we can position them in any direction we want for the best sound possible in our setup. So the first thing we're going to want to do is loosen these two outer screws inside of the bracket. After you take those out, you're going to want to loosen this middle screw here so we can adjust the swivel bracket. Now as you start to twist the swivel bracket, you'll see where the holes of the bracket start to align with the holes inside of the speaker. And after we find a position we like, we can take the screws and screw them back into the bracket, which will lock the speakers in that position. Next, we can take one of these rubber pads, take the tape off to reveal the adhesive, and stick it right on top of the bracket. This is gonna help keep the speakers from sliding around on your bar. Next, we can grab a pair of these rings that are gonna fit best on our bar. Since the bar we're using today is a bit on the thin side, I'm gonna use the 1.75 inch rings. So now we can take one of these rubber slips and place them right inside of the rings here. Now if one rubber slip won't be enough to hold the ring in place with your bar, you can actually stack up these rubber strips for a more secure fit. Now I can insert these rings onto the bar where I want to hang my speakers. So next we can take our speaker and line it up to the bar in between the two rings here. Then we can slide our rings onto the bracket where the holes of the rings line up to the holes of the bracket. Now while the speaker is hanging still right now, it's not fully secured to the bar just yet. This is where the screws, washers, and nuts come in. So we'll first take a couple of screws and washers and feed the washers right through the screws here. Then we're going to take the two screws and feed them all the way through the holes here on the bracket. Then we're going to take two nut pieces and screw them onto the back of the screws. Now on the back of the rings, you'll notice these grooves here that will hold your nuts in place as you're tightening your screws. So now that both of our speakers are mounted, I'm going to take the wire harness and plug it to the back of the active speaker. Now you also want to make sure that the wires from your harness match up with the wire connection points from the back of your speaker. So now to connect the two speakers together, I'm going to take the gray and black wires. I'm going to take the gray positive wire and plug it into the positive push terminal on the back of my passive speaker. Then I'm going to take the black negative wire and plug that into the negative push terminal on the back of the speaker. Now for today, we're just going to be using a battery to power these speakers. So I'm going to take the red and yellow wire and connect them to the positive terminal of our battery. Then I'm going to take the black wire and connect that to the negative terminal of our battery. And again, if you're connecting these speakers to a vehicle, the yellow wire will go to the positive terminal of your battery, the black wire will go into the negative terminal of your battery or the metal chassis of your vehicle, the red wire will go into the 12 volt ignition switch, and the blue wire goes right to your head unit. Now since we're not connecting these speakers to a head unit, we don't have to worry about the blue wire, but again we would want to connect it to the remote terminal of the head unit. And again, we'll want to connect the RGB cables of both speakers with this RGB extension cable so that both speakers light up with the LEDs. You just want to be sure to line up the arrows on both RGB cables so that they fit correctly. Now we can use the included wireless remote to control the LEDs built inside the speakers. So we can use the power button here to turn them on. As you can see, we have a button right in the middle for demo mode where the lights will flash in between red, green, and blue. On the top and bottom, you'll see two mode buttons where we can switch in between the different modes built into the LED lights, including various strobe and fade modes between all the colors or by themselves. These speakers have a ton of different colors, including red, green, blue, light green, light blue, yellow, purple, orange, teal, and much more. There's a number of different combinations you can use with the LED speakers, so if you surf through these mode buttons, you'll find the right display for your setup. You can also control how fast or how slow the colors will fade into each other with these speed buttons here. You can also set the lights to one static color using these color buttons here. And when you use these buttons, you'll set the speakers into that one static color. And you can also adjust the overall brightness of the LEDs with the brightness buttons here. Now there's a couple of different ways we can play music through the speakers. One being using the included aux cable and aux input to connect your music device. And the other being Bluetooth compatibility. To do that, you'll first want to go into the Bluetooth settings of your smartphone or tablet, search for the device that reads PT65BR, click on it to pair, and you'll know your device is connected when you hear that sound. So now let's play some music and hear how these speakers sound. So hopefully this showed you guys how easy it is to set up your PT65BR 6.5 inch powered Bluetooth LED tower speakers. But of course, if you have any questions, comments, or concerns, feel free to reach out to our customer support team through phone or email. As always, I'm Perry from Rockville, and we'll see you guys next time.